Long time no see. Welcome to 5 Games 5 Minutes from acornelectron.co.uk. Barbarian 2 is a superior Acornsoft title, and its loading screen and presentation indicates something special is on the way. Visually, it's really quite a stunner. It's got sprites that are huge and very impressively animated, and the backdrops, set over 4 levels, are similarly gorgeous. The aim is to explore the wastelands, the caverns, and the dungeons, and then to use the mystical objects you find on those levels to defeat the dreaded big boss on level 4. You can play as either man or woman. Now you may sense a bug coming, so here it is. The game looks great, but there is an unhealthy combination of being pushed into pits by the monsters, being backed into corners by the monsters and not being able to fight back, turning around for no particular reason in the middle of fighting monsters, suddenly finding that the game is loading in the next level before you've found all the objects that you need to find on the current one, and falling flat on your face as you simply walk around. This makes it very nice to watch someone else play, but very frustrating to actually play yourself. Hopper is pretty much part of whatever iconic image the Electron has. You play a number of humble frogs who need to get from one side of a busy motorway to the other, without being flattened by the traffic. Make it, and you then have to get across a pond by leaping on logs and turtles. The final jump is the hardest, as you must jump into a smallish space from the last moving log. Now Hopper is an exercise in simplicity. Its first sheet is easy as pie, after which it starts to speed up, and on later sheets you get a patrolling snake on the partition between road and pond. You also get turtles being replaced by water lilies, which you need to be much more cautious about jumping on. The game has all of the sprightly music you can hear, and it's colourful, noisy, and definitely worth a few moments of anyone's time. The same game format was cloned by many Electron software houses, but Hopper was, and is, the definitive version. There's also a German version of it too. Now, I don't think that there were many other text-only games that captured the imagination of school children up and down the UK as much as Kevin Tom's Football Manager. In 1984, this programme was considered one of the greatest games of all time, with school children battling their way through a number of football matches. From the bottom of Division 4 to the top of Division 1 and winning the FA Cup on top, Football Manager brought millions of us many hours of happiness. And this is said as someone who doesn't even really like football. Playing it now, it still retains some of that allure. As much fun as the game itself is the additional customizer program, into which you can add the names of your friends or work colleagues, allocate skill levels to, and then buy and sell in the main game by loading them into it. It would have been nice, of course, if the game had included at least a small graphical depiction of the match itself, and by modern standards, text-only football is always going to be a bit boring. Rick the Roadie is a game of 3 levels, tied together with the dubious premise of the hero, Rick, needing to set up the equipment for the gig of a band called Alternative Rock. On level 1, you've got to drive Rick's van through heavy traffic, for almost 10 minutes or so. This is doable, just, by learning how the road operates. Basically, you need to speed up, slow down, and weave left and right, treating the other cars as if they're a slowly scrolling maze. On the second level, by far the easiest, you have to walk Rick from one side of the screen to the other whilst he carries amplifiers and speakers. Finally, in a complete anti-climax, you have to set the sound levels on the equipment that Rick's assembled, without blowing the fuses. If you can do all 3 levels within the time limit, you get to see a good, for the Electron, congratulations screen. The game is below par, even for budget game standards. It only cost a few quid, but it's disappointing stuff. Phantom is a lavish overhead maze game, in which you control a professor tasked with traversing 4 buildings. The maze is split into rooms which, without exception, are patrolled by ghosts and monsters. The maze is narrow, making these phantoms extremely difficult to avoid. In a nod to the movie Ghostbusters, you do have a proton gun to blast them, but it has a very limited battery life and should be used sparingly. If your heart rate reaches 100 beats per minute, then you'll have a heart attack and die. The game looks good, has a fairly straightforward premise, reacts well and has good sound. The beating heartbeat is very welcome, and these qualities should make Phantom one of the better Electron games. But oddly, you can't get very far in the game without dying. This is because avoiding Phantoms isn't enough. Even if they pass near to your professor, your heart rate increases. Because the gun runs out, and the maze is narrow, you've got practically zero chance of the Phantoms never coming near you, so even getting to level 2 is something of an achievement.